Hey, you have mosquitoes in your arm too.
Oh yeah. Mosquitoes everywhere, huh?
Yeah. They biting me too. Yeah.
Little mommy's enjoying being outside. Yeah, it's not hot anymore. Salud, bebe. Daddy's over here working. Sealing the hole.
Watery.
Yeah. Charlie and Manny are on the way. They called me that they are at the border, so I'm getting ready for them. This one is already leveled. It's it fit here with concrete. The hole is done. Other one is done too. I'm cutting the rebars now. Yeah, I know. It's overkill. And two more rebar are gonna go on the top. It's gonna be really durable because they're gonna park here with the RV and with their car too. I ordered 14 cubic meter gravel. We have some sand, and I connected the water to the tank. This side is ready with the wiring. Come on the top, and this is the other. I'm just gonna start wiring now. My wife says it's overkill, but not to forget, it has to handle a Class A motorhome. So what do you think? Can it hold a Class A motorhome if this is filled up with concrete? And the top is gonna be about 2-3 inches concrete too. I think it will do the job. Let me know. It's 5:30. Oh man, almost done. I have some more wiring. My wife just left, went to Oxo for some beer because Charlie and Manny is on the way, and she left me little poopy bands. Thank you. Charlie and Manny is here. They are port workers. Manny! He's shy. You're not shy, Charlie, huh?
You know what you could do is put some of these bags in here.
Yeah.
You have the muscles.
I have the muscles, right. Next day, 12 o'clock, folks. Almost 12, at least. Manny, Charlie, and I finished these two septic lines. Very durable, overkill. Right now, we do that slab. Right now, having a break. It's very hot. And yeah, hey boys. Good job, guys.
Just wait for somebody to come and work.
So this is actually deeper than 4 inch because we didn't fill it up. I have the incoming and the outgoing line, and I'm gonna have the filters here and pressure tank there. And we left some space here for the sliding door. Right now running out of sand, so we're waiting on sand. And this is Manny's mixer, as I said yesterday. He brought it. So it makes it a lot easier. And we are done, 1 o'clock. The whole thing is poured, and the guys just went to Guaymas to get more 2x4 because we're gonna pour a slab in the back tomorrow. We're gonna pour our porch, and I just gonna go to Frank right now. He has a bobcat, maybe he rented that for me, and I'm gonna hold this in inside in the back in this one, so we don't have to wheelbarrow the whole 65 load. It's probably gonna be 65 load, the half of the slab, and the other half of the slab we're gonna do the day after tomorrow. I'm gonna go and water these concretes. Sorry guys that I wasn't recording the progress, but we've been just busy. In the morning we poured that small little slab here for the sliding gate. The other one is already drying. And why we're doing this here is because we hired a backhoe who would move that pile and that pile to the back so we can pour another slab. But in order to do that, we have to move the trailer first to the back, and we're still waiting on the guys.
This morning I went to school, the guys are working, and my dad is working too. Hey dad!
Hey.
So the guys are working now, and we have the car here, and I went to school and all this stuff we have to do. And we're here to, Charlie and Manny were here this morning. They went to did cement. I did my name on it. So, the guys are working right now. So, they were just, working all these stuff. So, they had the bucket, and they were left, and my dad here now, and all these stuff we have to do, and then We have the stuff here.
She's the boss. Jefe.
And here, that he's here.
Señor Carlos.
Hola. Okay. And our house is here, and now my dad clean here, and then they leave the stuff here. And there's the cars from here. And then, okay. See you later.
We have the wheels here. Put it next to it, man. Let me see. It doesn't fit. These are too big. Moment of truth. Captain Dan is here with his 3500 dually. They are raising the level, so we can hook it up. And we have two tires there, one there at the other side. But it's holding up. The whole weight is actually on this side, and it's balancing. I hope it's not gonna tip over. The final moments, folks. So excited. Captain Dan is pushing the trailer. And to navigate it in, it's really not easy. He doesn't have much space to turn this thing. And right there, the tire can hit the concrete pad. Good. So far. Babe. M. No, no.
Do you guys know right where he wants that? Give me a mark so I can guide
you. Okay, I need to talk to him. So yeah, the frame, the two frame has to go on exactly to the middle of those pads. Look at this. Wow, man. Can't believe it. Beautiful. Oh, look.
Daddy, I'm coming up there.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, her. No, honey, you can't.
I'm coming.
And we are done, guys. I can't believe it. Finally. Hey. the holes here for the filters and for the incoming. That's the inlet pipe. This is the out. You recording? Hi guys. Finally, we're here doing the water system, which is awesome. So inlet, filter, small pump, filter goes to the tank, and then from the tank, pressure tank, and here's the app. We're gonna have electricity here, a box for washer, dryer, and for the pumps. Easy peasy. As I drill them in before I put it in, I have some cement mixed with water, so they're gonna hold a lot tighter. Maybe I don't have to, but you know, my middle name is Overkill. Meanwhile, the holes are drilled and the anchors are in. I just had to do something else. I was doing electricity because my small drill overheated, but I was doing the electric boxes and waterproofing it. So now that this is ready, I'm gonna mix a little bit of concrete, really wet, and pour into those holes, and then I'm gonna tie the screws. And I have this one under here because we have some level differences.
Setting up this pipe. That's the way to do it. I mean, if you want to do something the right way and the strong way. Right, love? You're sick.
Trust me, it's a secret. It's a curse. Especially here in Mexico. Crazy. Maybe a little bit more. Maybe you are getting tired watching concrete videos, but I promise this is the last one. Almost done. Having fun in the sun. Oh, what a poetry. Yep. Ready. Almost ready for the folks. Oh yeah. 6 o'clock in the morning. And the hardest things are ready. All the concrete stuff, the water, electricity. One thing I forgot. And I'm working on it right now. Here's that little piece of pipe. This is the sewage, the drainage pipe for this RV. Yeah, I put it far away from that, but they can connect it here too. It doesn't matter which way you connect. It's just a lot shorter right here. But as you know, we have a leach field here, so nothing is supporting that pipe. Really, it's just, it would be only in gravel. So I'm putting the rebar and connecting them right now. It's a lot of rebar right there. I have rebar on the bottom, on the top, and I have this plastic here so the cement wouldn't sink into the leach field. That's what I'm doing today, or at least in the morning, because 9 o'clock I have to take this great help back to where it belongs. This is a mixer, and it was really a great help. Man, if I knew that before, that you can rent these things out. You know, I used to mix the cement in a wheelbarrow, and this is like, what, 300 pesos for a whole day. So like $15 for a whole day. Really worth it.